Joe is such an extraordinary icon, but like most symbols, it's so powerful because of its links with our memories of the University of Birmingham. It relates to the vision of the founders of the university. It was always to be beautiful, and it was always to be useful.
The university buildings here, known as the Aston Webb complex, were designed by Sir Aston Webb and Edward Ingress Bell. Construction began in about 1901. There were always plans for there to be a clock tower included in the complex, but it wasn't until 1905 that enough money had been raised to construct this in addition to the other buildings. And it was at this point that Joseph Chamberlain, who was the first Chancellor of the university and had been instrumental in raising funds, became directly involved in the design. He wanted it really to be based on the Torre del Mangia in Sienna, which is, if you've seen it, a very similar looking tower, except that the clock tower is at the base rather than towards the top.
Some people claim that old Joe's the inspiration for Tolkien's Twin Towers in Lord of the Rings. And it might sound a bit far-fetched, but actually Tolkien was at school just across the road at King Edward's. This tower loomed large in his young life.
There's a bar in the Students' Union that's named after it. It's got its own Twitter feed. It's often used as a logo in student magazines.
But it's not just beautiful. It's useful too. It's Ruskin's vision of beauty. In the Second World War, the revolutionary radar inventors working at the University of Birmingham used the tower in their tests. In a way, it's kind of a symbol of our liberty. But in truth, it isn't always in the forefront of our minds, but it emerges from the background, sometimes because students are protesting around it, but probably most importantly, and most regularly, because students are celebrating at the foot of Old Joe at the end of the congregations and the awards of degrees each year.